As all of you must be knowing, after the implementation of the neoliberal policies in 1991, the Indian public sector has come under waves of attack from the government. And so far as the telecommunication is concerned, till 2000, the government was the government service provider, and it was, the job was done by Department of Telecommunications. And in the year 2000, the operations being done by Department of Telecommunication was transferred to a public sector company, Bharat Sanchar Nigam Limited. It came into existence in 1st October 2000. In fact, being the trade unions in the Department of Telecommunications, we severely opposed the formation of a corporation, because we know that formation of the corporation is the first step towards privatization. So the whole idea of the government is to privatize the entire telecommunication services. And way back in 1995, licenses were given to private operators to start services. And after formation of BSNL, immediately after formation of BSNL, government started taking steps for privatization. They wanted to start disinvestment. They want to implement retrenchment, because there was a very big workforce in BSNL. So for disinvestment and for compulsory retirement scheme, CRS, steps were taken way back in 2002-03. But the trade unions in telecommunication are successful installing the disinvestment as well as compulsory retirement scheme or voluntary retirement scheme, for which various efforts were made during the past 18 years. And I am proud to say that till today, BSNL remains as a 100% government-owned company. We have frustrated all the efforts of the government to start disinvestment. But after having failed to start disinvestment in BSNL, government resorted to other methods of weakening BSNL. Prior to the lunch, I was able to hear little bit from what the comrade from Airlines, Air India, was presenting. Meticulous steps were taken to weaken BSNL, just as was done in the case of Air India. So now it is very easy for the government to tell the people of the country, yeah, Air India is a loss making. How long can we run that organization with the people's money? So now there is not even a murmur from the public against the privatization of Air India. I think today you might have gone through newspapers. Three major airways of the country, Jet Airways, Indigo, SpiceJet, three of these airlines have been fined by the Competition Commission of India to the tune of 54 crore rupees. Why? They formed the cartels among themselves and raised the fuel surcharge and thereby looted. So if Air India is not there, it will become very easy for the private companies to form cartels among themselves and rule the people. Similarly, government take various steps to weaken BSNL. The very big step taken by them was to deny equipment supply to BSNL. BSNL is a government company. There are procedures We have to, we can procure equipments for our network expansion only through tenders. And right from 2006 up to 2012, government found various ways and means to stop our equipment procurement. The famous Mr. A. Raja, when he was our minister, he cancelled our tender, BSNL's tender, to procure 45 million line equipments. And it is an open secret, to benefit the private operators, if BSNL is not able to procure equipment, if BSNL is not able to upgrade or expand its network, naturally the beneficiaries will be the private operators. From 2006 up to 2012, the mobile services grew exponentially. But unfortunately, due to denial of equipment procurement, BSNL was not able to utilize that exponential growth. And in 2010, another mega tender floated by BSNL to procure 93 million line equipments. It was cancelled by the Home Ministry under the pretext that the lowest bidder was a Chinese company. China is our enemy country. BSNL is a government company. BSNL cannot procure equipment from a Chinese company. Even at that time, 2010, almost all the private operators were procuring equipment from Chinese companies. And if today, Huawei, ZTE have emerged as major players, as major equipment vendors in India. Everybody is procuring equipment with them. But BSNL's tender was cancelled because lowest bidder was Chinese company. So in this manner, either the minister or the ministry, continuously for 6 years, they scuttled BSNL's network expansion program, as a result of which our services went to the dogs. People started criticizing our quality of service. And I am proud to say, BSNL Employees Union, the biggest union, trade union of BSNL, we were able to unite even the associations of officers. The officers and employees, workers joined together, and almost for the past one decade, we are fighting against the nefarious game plan of the government to kill BSNL. And we have gone on strike against cancellation of our tenders. We have gone on strike, various strike, 1 day strike, 2 day strike, 3 day strike, indefinite strike, numerous strikes. And because of our struggles, management and government was compelled to make equipment procurement. And from 2013 onwards, three phases of network expansion has taken place. And today, I am proud to say, BSNL, its market share was around 8%, and as of December 31st, 2017, BSNL's market share has risen to 10.10%. We have been able to increase the market share. And another thing I want to tell, it is very important for the trade unions to learn lesson. The media and the corporates, consistently they are making a propaganda that the services of public sector is not up to the mark of the private sector, and we have to take care of it. And the unions and associations in BSNL have taken note of it, and consistently, on one side we were fighting against the anti-BSNL policies of the government, and simultaneously we have taken care to improve the work culture of the employees. Together with our strike, we have conducted massive signature campaign among the public, and we have submitted the signatures to the Prime Minister. And when we go to the people and the people express their unhappiness about our quality of service and the way our employees interact with the public, especially this applies to public sector companies which are providing services. So We have launched a campaign called Customer Delight Movement way back in 2013. Customer Delight Movement. And we have told our people that our work culture needs to be improved. Our attitude towards the people needs to be improved, because we know without the support of the people, it will be next to impossible to stop the privatization moves of the government. And we have told our employees that you have to become customer friendly. And I am glad to say that we have made significant improvement in this regard also. And another thing, equipments companies started procuring equipments, and we involved the employees in what you call improving the customer base, quality of service. We have conducted campaign, for example, from January 2016, we launched another campaign, Service with a Smile. Service with a Smile, SWAS. And through these movements, we have told our people that our employees have to actively participate in the financial revival of BSNL. As a result, when very good, you may be knowing, BSNL was the first company to launch free roaming. And unfortunately, we didn't have much resources to engage brand ambassadors to. So what we did? We told our people that you have to go to the people, and the employees, including officers, conducted road shows, mailers, and they took the message to the people that BSNL has launched so many good programs. And talking about future, today all the private operators are providing 4G service. BSNL is not able to provide. But getting 4G equipment from government is not an easy thing. We have to spend 16,000 crore rupees. BSNL is not having money. Another important thing I want to tell. Airtel, the biggest service provider, its loan, bank loan, comes to 91,000 crore rupees. Even the great Reliance Jio is having a bank loan of 60,000 crore rupees, and BSNL's loan debt is almost nil. We are a debt-free company. So, we have told the government that since you have retarded the growth of BSNL for 6-7 years, you have to give some concession. I am proud to say, we had a discussion with the Honorable Minister of State for Communications on 24. We told him, look sir, when flood came in Chennai, all the private operators shut down their services and ran away. It was BSNL which provided service for relief and rescue works. It's not only in Chennai, whether it is Srinagar flood, whether it is Vishakhapatnam cyclone, whether it is Odisha cyclone, it was BSNL which remained in the field and which has helped the people. Please don't treat BSNL at par with private companies. So now BSNL has submitted a scheme for allotment of 4G spectrum, according to which 50% of the spectrum charge will be paid by the company, and 50% of the spectrum charge will be treated as capital infusion by the government. And I am glad to say that our minister has accepted for this proposal. Soon, BSNL will get 4G spectrum, and by the end of this 2018, BSNL will be in a position to provide 4G service. And I am very hopeful. Yes, tooth and nail we are fighting against the disinvestment privatization policies of the government. And at the same time, on the other side, we have motivated the employees, and we have told them that we have to provide quality service to the people, otherwise it will be difficult to survive in the market. And I am very hopeful that the employees of BSNL and the BSNL as an organization is having a very good future, and certainly within our net loss It was 8,500 crore in 2014-15. We have brought down to almost 4,000 crore. And factors like this geo factor, demonetization, and GST had all these problems not been there. Even in the last financial year, our net loss would have been reduced to the area of 2,000 crore. Very soon, within a year or two, we will bring BSNL out of loss and we will make it a profit-making company. And according to me, there is a very good bright future for the company and the employees. Thank you.